have for us? Oh, look at that, kids. Yeah. We have some dog bones.
Look at
this. This is a surprise. Voila.
Oh, and a steak for me. Look at that, kids. Wow. Oh, I like the dog bones. Thank
delicious.
You very much. Here, Josephine, give this nice gentleman the tip. There you go. Oh, whoa. Oh.
Who let the dogs out?
I'll give it to you. There you go.
Josephine.
Who let the dogs out?
Enjoy. What that? What do you got? Give me that back! Give me! I can't believe you got that. Oh, boy. Turn my back for 2 minutes. Who's that?
Ken, who's that? Are you in here? I let myself in.
Oh, hey, where are you? Hey, Ursula, how are you?
Oh, hey.
I was just giving the kids a tour.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Look at the Prime Minister's suite.
Oh, my God.
Something?
I love it.
Yeah.
This is so cool.
Isn't this beautiful?
Look at the sunlight that just comes in.
Yeah,
oh, my God.
I know. The fireplace. Everything.
Ken.
Yeah. Yeah. What?
You might want it.
Oh, dear. It wasn't me.
Well, shouldn't we clean that up?
No, it's a dog-friendly hotel. Don't worry about it.
Hi, welcome back.
Yes.
Hi.
Thank you for having us.
Not
and it's
at
been
all.
Going well.
It's been going well. I'm very glad to hear that. How can I help you today?
Well, we still have the issues with Napoleon. He's been on a diet.
Mm.
And he's been doing a bit of exercise. He's praying to you
I
now.
See that.
He's praying.
That's actually quite good. If you can get him to keep doing that a lot, that burns a lot of calories.
It does. Yeah, he'll do that. Won't you? Won't you, fat boy? Yeah.
I'm sorry, did you say Fat Boy?
Yeah.
Huh? That's his nickname, Fat Boy.
Fat Boy.
Yeah. Fat Boy.
Well, I see now why your dog has an eating disorder.
Why is that?
You just called him F Boy. Now,
Fat Boy. I mean, look at him.
Look, I'm not surprised that your dog has an eating disorder at all.
But look, I mean,
whether or not he has a weight problem, that can be extremely detrimental to a dog's...
He's like a little bear.
Frankly, I'm shocked right now.
Why?
You can't... Whether it be a pet name or not, this
fat
person
boy.
Nickname cannot... You can't call a dog that.
I call him fatness sometimes.
You've damaged his aura. Napoleon came in again today. He doesn't look too much better physically or emotionally from what I read. But the fact that Ken calls him Fat Boy was very distressing for me because, I mean, I may not look it now, but when I was younger, a few years back, I was also teased about my weight. I was a little overweight. And things didn't turn out too well.
I won't call him Fat Boy anymore.
No more Fat Boy.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
Nappy. I call him Nappy sometimes.
That's fine. I don't see how that could be detrimental.
Napsters?
But I also want you to go see a woman that I know.
Myself?
No. Well, that couldn't hurt.
that couldn't hurt. I'm seeing three right now. Okay.
But I would like you to go see a woman to repair the damage that you've done to his aura.
What's she gonna do to him?
She's going to perform Reiki on him. Just give her a call.
Okay.
Tell her I referred you, and
we'll take him.
Let
there.
Me know how things go, and the session is done.
The guy's screwballs.
The guy's
a conehead. The session's done.
Like, what was that about? I'm gone.
It was like he said his piece. It was like he was God, and then he just disappears.
Yeah. Yeah, it was very zen-like. That's what it was. Very zen-like.
Yeah, very interesting guy, I must say.
I wouldn't go that far.
So we're hoping that you can help out with the kids so that they behave at the wedding, they don't create any scenes.
You work with Reiki, right?
Yes, I'm a Reiki practitioner.
You're a Reiki practitioner, and you're going to actually, you want to do some on the fat one?
Well, basically what I do is I channel energy, and we channel it through my hands into the dog.
Okay.
And help to balance his energy centers.
Oh.
You know, the chakras, just like with people, animals have them as well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's actually really calm. I don't know if he needs a whole lot of adjustment. Yeah. What about you?
Oh, huh? She's the one.
Okay,
there we go. There we go. There. There.
She's going to keep crawling back.
Oh.
Aww, she's a little nervous. That's understandable.
All right. Yeah.
That's understandable. It's okay. I'm not going to come too close, hon.
Look at that.
All right.
I think I feel the energy.
After the dog whisper, I gotta tell you, the Reiki woman made sense. And after she finished, I felt completely relaxed and ready for the wedding. So we're just gonna get them in their outfits. We'll be in the limo. Look at Ursula. Look at his little outfit.
Oh my God.
Look, I just want you to see. Look at him with his little. Isn't that beautiful?
Our little kids.
Aren't we excited?
Oh my God.
Are you excited?
I'm so excited.
You're beyond yourself.
I can't wait until people see her walking down the aisle. I can't wait to see the reaction.
I know, look at her,
like,
she's already.
She's so cute.
Okay, so where's his top hat?
Oh, I got it.
Okay, there we go, we're all ready. And this is it now.
This is it.
So, you know what? Thank you very much. Don't you gotta get ready?
Oh my God, yes. Oh my God, okay.
Because you're walking her down the aisle, so. No, don't be late.
I won't.
Okay,
I won't.
See you in a minute.
God. Okay, see you. Bye.
Whoops. Oh, poor thing. There we go. We're all ready to go to the wedding.
Look at the nice limousine we're in. This is your wedding limousine. Yeah, I know, Josephine, it's your wedding limousine. Oh, kiss me, kiss your dad. Yeah, yeah, that's, yeah, that's for your gown.
And I don't want anybody bolting at the altar, do you hear that? No bolting at the altar. Okay, you're a good boy. Almost there.
Well, I'm happy this day is finally here. I'm the grandmother of the groom. I'm very concerned about him. Between you and me, I heard he's marrying a real bitch.
Hi, I'm Ian. I'm part of the catering crew. This was my day off, but dog wedding. Am I happy to be here? Well, whatever.
Jenny? Hi, sweetie. How are you?
Good,
nice to see
you.
Let me give you a
good.
It looks amazing. It
does,
so good.
Yeah.
You know, everything is ready to go for the wedding. We have everything put in place. All the details are done. We've been working like dogs for hours. And then Justin comes up to me and Jamie and says, hey, there's these flowers you gotta put away here. And there's one vase that was probably as tall as me, probably weighed as much as me, maybe more.
This one, the big one, goes up on the altar. It's quite.
He also wanted us to lift it quite high. And I'm pretty sure that wasn't, that was a safety concern for me. I mean, I've been trained in Wemyss. I felt for my own safety and Jamie's safety, it would be better if we just kind of put that big, heavy vase just out of the way and we could make do with the smaller flower. The place looked so beautiful, I didn't really think that the flowers would make that much of a difference. I was told afterwards by Justin that Mr. Kostick built it.
I mean, that has to be fixed.
Yes,
is there something going up?
No, there is. There's an arrangement. I'll get it.
Because that's not good.
No, don't worry.
I don't want to throw a hiss fit, but that's not good.
You don't have to. We have another arrangement.
Ken did not like that at all. He hasn't actually talked to me about it yet. I think Adam's got the brunt of that so far. So, to be honest, that's fine with me.
I was a little shocked,
Ken didn't really tell me how elaborate it was. I saw it on black and white on paper. But to see it out there, I mean, wow, for a doggy wedding, that was pretty out there. Ken. Yeah. Honey.
What?
This is beautiful. This is beautiful. You did a great job.
Okay.
But how fucking much is this?
Oh, don't worry about that. We've gotta run. It's
the big day is here. It's finally here. The big Chihuahua wedding at Causeway Center in Toronto. We're really, really excited. Napoleon and Josephine, they got some spa treatment. They're relaxing in the Prime Minister's suite at the Royal York, so not only are you good looking, but you did a good job. Are you married? You married?
So this is all for the doggies, right?
No. You can give it to the dog.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding you. Is there any reason why they're not here?
I'm assuming they're just caught in traffic. I know.
Ken, you know, normally comes across like he's calm, collected, has it all together, but I actually saw him snapping at someone. I was like, oh my God. But yeah, so, you know, he might act that way, but, you know, sometimes he needs to let it out. And sometimes I think it's good that he does.
And how dare this group tell me where I can do business?
Again, it's not that you sell the product
there. Oh, it is. Don't sugarcoat it.
Yeah, actually, this can't be taped. Sorry.
Well, this is going, I should tell you,
yeah,
the whole thing is going in a documentary.
Yeah, I can't.
I think what happens with charities a lot of times is when they involve politics, they really lose focus of what they want to do. And all we wanted to do is have a big Chihuahua wedding, and Napoleon and Josephine give all the funds to this wonderful charity, and they had to just be weird about it.
And is that so hard?
Yeah, that's
it. Is it so hard to want to accept the check? Because, hey, then, I mean, who else are we gonna give money to?
Well, we found someone.
Yeah, we did.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. So that's great. Tell them who the charity is.
The charity is the Lions Organization of Canada Guide Dogs.
Yeah. And the good thing about them is not only do they help dogs, but they're helping people.
How's everybody? Good. Well, we'd like to welcome you all here to the Causeway Center. For a big event. It's kind of twofold. I didn't tell anyone I'm getting married. No. I don't think I'd go through that again. This was a lot of work. So we have the my two Chihuahuas, Napoleon and Josephine, and they're getting hitched.
I think
today,
if somebody wants to celebrate a union between two dogs, why not? As for other marriage, you know, we have to definitely include all people and make sure that it's equal rights for everybody.
I was just getting tired of hearing Ken talk about this on a regular basis. Yip, 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 yip. Dog wedding, Chihuahuas, Josephine, Napoleon. Bah, 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 bah.
At this time, I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce Dr. Ted Morris, the Toronto comic and vet who is officiating and gonna marry the couple. Dr. Ted?
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. It's nice to see all your smiling and or drooling faces in here. This is actually the first dog wedding I've ever officiated, which I'm very excited for. I wasn't sure what to wear. I was just going to wear a collar and a leash, but it's Friday of Pride weekend, so I kind of ran out of those. Now, if we could start, we have a lovely ceremony prepared for you, and I'd like to start by introducing the bridal party. First off, we've got Jasper. Jasper is a 9-year-old Portuguese water dog. He is a very chatty fellow. He's a real conversationalist, so go chat him up after the ceremony. He's also very independent and often insists on walking himself. He's an avid diver and swimmer, and today he's accompanied by his proud owner, Tag.
It's just weird. It's just really, really weird that we're actually talking about a big Chihuahua wedding, and who would have thought that it actually came out better than a lot of real life weddings.
And now we've got Timber, who's an 8-year-old husky wolf cross being walked up by his sister Katie and his mom Christy. He's very intrigued with what's down there. What's going on, Timber?
I really loved the aisle. Bella did a wonderful job on that aisle. I want that aisle when I get married, so with all the moss.
And now making her way up the aisle is Rosie. Rosie's 4-year-old Bichon Frise, and in spite of what she looks like, she will in fact eat the mailman. She hates him. She can sense him a mile away. She is not as sweet as she looks. Hi, gorgeous. That's the next ceremony. And last, but certainly not least, we have our best man, Casper, making his way up. He is 4 years old, he is a Chihuahua, and this is a little bit awkward. He's also in love with the groom.
Just going down that aisle and seeing everyone, the procession, made me feel accomplished. It made me feel that this is it. This is what we worked so hard for, was to get these two pups married, and we actually pulled it off. We pulled it off in such a way that was phenomenal.
Don't look so worried, my friend.
He's a little nervous.
No. The worry's for after the ceremony.
Okay. Normally, I really love watching the groom watch the bride go down the aisle, but because they were dogs, they weren't really paying attention to each other. But Josephine looked just as stunning as any other bride that I've seen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and welcome our bride.
Wow, well, I was a little nervous to begin with because I was so scared. I didn't know what was going to happen. What was Josephine going to do? Was she going to take a fit, you know? But, you know, she did give me a hard time. Like, she didn't want to walk, so I had to end up holding her, which was okay. Kind of weird. I ended up stepping on that grass thing on the crown. I had no idea that was going to be there.
Small wardrobe malfunction.
Yeah, for the most part, it went pretty good.
She's cute, isn't she?
Yes.
Ursula looked hot today. I must say hot pink is good for her. as long as we're not wearing the same thing, I think Ursula and I are going to be great friends. I really do. Yeah.
It is true love. Please be seated. Today we bear witness to the joining of 2 hearts, 8 legs, and 2 tails. From the moment they first met and sniffed each other, they knew this was not just any old bum they were sniffing. No, this was a bum they would sniff for the rest of their lives. Much like their namesakes, Josephine captured Napoleon's heart, and he was unable to resist. Or to paraphrase some wise Swedish poets, my, my, to Josephine, Napoleon did surrender. Hi, buddy. And just a few points of order. If the guests could refrain from peeing on the floral arrangements or eating them until the ceremony's over, that would be great.
Oh, the favorite part was when Napoleon was actually barking and responding to Ted's vows.
Are you?
So that was priceless. That was so adorable.
Do you promise to share your treats and your toys and the laps of your loved ones until your muzzle goes gray and your eyes go milky?
I think that Josephine and Napoleon are definitely a great couple. They seem to love each other, and I think they're definitely going to stay together.
Josephine, my sweet, do you take Napoleon to be your dog, forsaking all other dogs before him? Do you promise to help him lift his leg to pee when he's old? Do you promise to let Napoleon be right sometimes? As even though he is neutered, he is still a man. And it is in the nature of men to
I would say right. Maybe the therapy that we did was beneficial to the dogs. Napoleon, you know, he will remain in his state. He still has issues. He needs to lose weight. He needs to get over his lack of, you know, a libido. Although his testicles were removed, I mean, you can still fake it, right?
And now, by the power vested in me, by me, I now pronounce you dog and wife. You may now sniff the bride.
I think the day was just grand. It was so beautiful, so over the top. It was everything that I have come to love and respect Mr. Ken Kostick for. And I am so grateful that I got to work this great event.
And again, thank you very much for coming out to the Big 2-Hour Wedding. We appreciate it.
This is the first dog wedding that I've ever officiated, and it was very exciting. Although I came here under false pretenses, because Ken doesn't know this, but Chihuahuas are my least favorite dogs to work on at work, and I actually have a big long routine about killing Chihuahuas. It's great. Every time a Chihuahua dies, an angel gets its wings.
Ted did an amazing job. But the gays love to marry people because they